Hey devs, welcome to Webstyle Press. If you are new to this channel, I invite you to subscribe and join us. Hit subscribe button and click bell icon. We have been using CSS floats to create grids. Now we have got flexbox and CSS grid techniques. CSS grid for video conferencing app is a special case scenario. It requires you to create blocks of content equal in height and width. By creating blocks of equal width height, you will be able to add remove blocks of content as needed. What do you see during a video conferencing? You see a grid layout with equal sized boxes. Each box contains a video. Whenever a person joins, another video box appears. Other boxes adjust to make room for the new video box. Each box is again of equal size. With JavaScript and ReactJS based apps, it is possible you can create video conferencing app for web easily. We want to create that video conferencing layout in CSS. We will use CSS grid and flexbox to create that. I have got this web page and there's a CSS custom.css linked to it. I am using SAS and the output for this SAS will be converted into custom.css file. And let's start and create the wrapper first. So here is the class and a div. The main class that I want to use is wrapper, and inside the wrapper I want to use another div with another class, and then I want to use a column. I will name it as col, C-O-L, and then here I want to use video, and let's use some content here, random content, a title. Maybe this much title is sufficient, and then an anchor, some link. So here will be the video. For this is my page, and there is some typo, I guess, href, and this is the extra bracket here, so we remove it. And for videos, you can search free sample videos, you can search text slides sample videos, and you can come here, and as you can see, you've got this video. I will just use this code here, and I will just use this code right here, and so this is our video, and we have got some title and then a link. So I will take it as my video box, and let's say this is the video. Let's write CSS for this. So we have got wrapper, inner, and col. So first of all, let's use box sizing. Set the box sizing to border box. Then our HTML, that will be of 100% height. And then we have got the body, that will also have 100% height. And then we have got margin, let's set to 0, and padding, let's set it to 10 pixels. And then we have got wrapper, and inside the wrapper we have got inner. Wrapper, inner and column. Column is alright. We will just need these. So for the wrapper we need 100% height. So for wrapper 100% height, and for body 100% height, and for the HTML 100% height. So this is essential because we want to use height 100% height for our layout. So we will turn the wrapper into grid, display grid. So this is grid, CSS grid, not flexbox. So this is our inner, and but before here will be the grid template columns. And those will be the repeat one fraction, and then here will be the grid template rows. Grid template rows, and these will repeat one fraction. So here is the inner. Let's see what we have got here. Same. Okay, so for inner we will use display flex. Let's turn it to flex. Align items, center, and justify content. Center, width 100%, and text line center. Let's use a background color. Background color. And we've got this. So column will cover all of this. This one. And now this is our video box. Let's give it a padding of 10 pixels. Okay. If I inspect this, so wrapper is taking 100% height, inner is not taking 100% height. We will have to use 100% height at the inner as well. Okay, for one video, let's say there's one video at the canvas, you can use settings like this. And let's move this thing in the HTML, and I will tell you why. Style, this one. Let's move it below. So consider that you're creating an app, and you need to create the columns and video boxes. All you have to do is to change these as these inner boxes will be added. So this inner box, this is our video box, one video box. As these will be added, you can count these video boxes, and then you can change these values to adjust the video boxes for your page. Let me explain. Let's say now you have got two video boxes here, and now two boxes should be in the same row. So what you will do is you will change this value from 1 to 2. So I have got a typo. It is grid, display grid. And then I also want to use grid gap here. Now if I see here, we have got two video boxes, and now I want to make these even more. So I want to use three video boxes. I will just copy this video box inner, and I have got now three boxes. So it means that grid template columns repeat three columns, and each column will be of one fraction. And here we have got grid template rows, and one row and one fraction. So now we see we have got three videos now. Let's add one more video. So now we will use four columns here, and now as you can see that here is this scroll. So we've got this video tag. Let's adjust this video tag. Let's make the width of video 100%. So now we don't have the horizontal scroll anymore. So what if we will have more videos? Let's say five videos. So we have got five videos now. So we will use four columns. For columns we will use four and one, but for rows now we will change 1 to 2 for rows. And as you can see, our content has been distributed, and our video boxes have equal sizes, and we can add videos to this page, and the content will adjust accordingly. And let's use another video box, and let's see now another video. Let's use another video box, and this is another video. Let's use another, and here goes another video. So let's use even more. So let's add four more videos. So for that we will need another raw now, right? So we will change this grid template rows. We have two rows now, we will use three rows, and we need four more videos. Three and four. Just copy and paste it here, and here we go. Now we have got full page videos. So in this way you can create video conferencing CSS grid layout by using CSS grid and flexbox. So in a real app, you will check number of or length of these video boxes, and you will change these numbers here accordingly. The rows you will need, how many rows you will need, and how many columns you will need, and this you will use this style. You can use the style inside your HTML, and you can manipulate the DOM or virtual DOM to change these values, and then our code will be like this. Remember to use height for HTML and body and set it to 100%, and then wrapper will also have 100% height, and it will be a display grid, and we have used some grid gap as well. And inner is our video box, main video box, that is flex. It is flex box, and its align item and justify content is center. And then our video is with the 100% width, so that it covers the whole box. That's it for me, guys. I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, you can comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.